Hello everyone, I'm Shweta and welcome to my channel Analytics by Shweta. In today's video, we will learn how to calculate the percent of row total in Power BI. First, let us look at our data model. If you see, we have three tables, the department and the gender. These are the dimension tables. They are connected to our fact table employee data in a one-to-many relationships. Now let us look at the contents of these tables. The department table is a list of all the available departments in our data set. Similarly, the gender table is a list of all the available gender categories in our data set. And finally, the employee data table is the details of all the active employees. So they have details like gender, department, grade, designations, date of joining, country, and many more details for our employees. So let's start the process of calculating the percent of row total. We will first start by adding a matrix visual into our report. Now, on the rows, we will add the department, and on the columns, we would add the gender. Now, what do we mean by percent of row total? What we mean is that in customer service, we want to calculate how many percent of those are females, how many percent are males, and how many percent is undisclosed. And the sum of this would be equal to 100%. So the first step, what we need to do is to calculate the headcount. The headcount measure is as follows. We count the employee code in the employee data table. As our employee data table does not have any duplicates, this measure will give us the headcount of all our available active employees. Now, if we pull this headcount onto the values, we will see that in customer service, we have 930 females, 530 males, and 39 of undisclosed gender. And in total, we have 1499 employees in customer service. Similarly, for all the other departments, we have similar information. The intent of calculating percent of row total is that we need to know in customer service, 930 accounts for how much percent of 1499. Similarly, 530 accounts for how much percent of 1499. And similarly, 39 accounts for how much percent of 1499. So the next step is to calculate the row total. So we'll calculate a new measure. We will write it as row total. And then we use calculate headcount. As we are calculating the percentage across the rows, we need to remove the filters across the columns. So our columns are the gender table. So we remove the filters across the gender and calculate the headcount. And we OK this measure. Now if we go to our visual and just duplicate this and remove the headcount from here and add the row total, you will see here in customer service we get 1499 in female, 1499 in male, and 1499 in undisclosed. So we have removed the filters across the gender. But this is not what we want. We want the percent values. So now we add a new measure to calculate the percent of row total. So we name our measure percent of row total. We use the divide measure. We divide the head count by the row total measure and we approve the measure. We format this measure as a percent and we round it off to zero values. Now let's again duplicate this matrix visual and remove the row total and add the percent of row total over here. Now if you look at these values, we get 62% in customer service department are females, 35% are males, and 3% are undisclosed, and the total of this is 100%. So the total of each rows comes out to 100%. So this is what we mean by percent of row total. We can just delete these visuals for the time being and have a look at this. The overall grand total is 14% females, 83% males, and 4% undisclosed. These percent values are for the entire organization. That means of all the headcount in our organization, we have around 14% females, 83% males, and 4% of undisclosed measure. So that brings an end to this video. If you like the contents of this video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for your time and have a nice day. Thank you.